Hey guys, and welcome to Pro Wrestling Unlimited on YouTube and Facebook, where we bring you the top news, rumors, stories, headlines, for fans, by fans. I'm going to tell you now, this might be a little longer video than normal, but let's get to it. Mick Foley has been posting on Facebook about how he is, you know, unhappy with the way the WWE is going and the direction of the product, and even said last week, if next week's Raw is not an improvement, he may never watch again, at least not for a long time. So this morning, we wake up to a pretty lengthy Facebook, you know, I don't want to say message, Facebook post by Mr. Foley, entitled, Final Raw for Foley. I'm going to read you some of it, paraphrase a little bit of it, give you the gist of what Foley had to say in his Final Raw for Foley Facebook post. And I quote, "Wrestling historians can argue when the Attitude Era in wrestling officially began. For me, it will always be a meeting called by Mr. McMahon in the spring of 1997, where he admitted that what had worked for them so long in the past, I interpreted that to meaning one-dimensional characters that tended to be job-related, was no longer working, and that if they were going to survive, the wrestlers themselves were going to have to step up and create the dimension that those established that also established bonds between the wrestler and the fans." Foley went on to say, "Today's superstars are at a distinct disadvantage in some ways. They can't flip birds, and they can't use colorful language. They can't bleed. Man, how Roman Reigns' life would be so much easier if he could survive vicious assaults, be left bloodied and unbowed, the way guys in my era did. All that pales in comparison to the real secret weapon of the Attitude Era, freedom. The freedom to create, the freedom to try, the freedom to fail. The idea of going out swinging was just as important as hitting one right out of the park, as long as you took your best swing at it. It's the difference between cutting a promo like Stone Cold Steve Austin or The Rock and the cookie-cutter approach all too often employed these days by WWE Creative. One style allowed for creativity and emotion, the other calls for memorization and recitation." Foley goes on saying, "I hope I don't sound like I'm picking on WWE. There is a big part of me that loves the company. Why else would I be doing this at 4:15 a.m., writing things that are likely to banish me deeper into the WWE doghouse?" Foley also mentioned that he was proposed by a superstar that one of his favorites, a 4 to 5 week storyline that he was for sure WWE was shut down due to the fact that he would go out there and talk off the script, trying to cause real emotion and, you know, do the things that they did in the 90s that saved that company. So what do you think of Foley's, you know, Final Raw for Foley message or post, whatever you want to interpret it as? I feel like Foley, like many fans, are fed up with the way the WWE is going, and you can tell week after week after week that it's the same stuff, just a little bit twisted to seem or fit a little bit differently, and that they're not coming up with new ideas or they're not trying to do new things that will make the product seem, you know, rejuvenated or refreshed or re-inspired by something else that we haven't seen before. So what do you guys think? Are you guys fed up like Foley with the WWE and the direction that the creative is going and the direction that the company is going? Are you guys going to continue to watch the WWE no matter what? Are you guys putting the WWE on a timetable like Mick Foley and saying, hey, you give me one more uninspired and unimproved week, I'm not going to watch anymore? I want your thoughts on Mick Foley and what he had to say here today. So remember, guys, comment below, like and share this video, like us on Facebook, and subscribe here on YouTube.